The fossil record shows that for the first 175 million years of their existence, dinosaurs took on a huge variety of forms as the environment changed and new species evolved that were suited to these new conditions. Dinosaurs that failed to adapt went extinct. But then, 66 million years ago, over a relatively short time, dinosaurs disappeared completely. Many other animals also died out, including pterosaurs, large marine reptiles, and ammonites. In this video, we are going to look at exactly what and how this happened. Along the Tanis River 66 million years ago, spring was in full swing. The river curved lazily through forest and wetland on its way to the Western Interior Seaway, a shallow sea several miles away that covered much of what is now North America's Great Plains. Plants were budding and starting to bloom, and turtles rested along the riverbanks. In the forest, the dinosaurs and outsize insects squawks and buzzes ring out as they whir to life. Little did they know that this was to be the last day this would happen. What is now known as Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula is the place where life for the dinosaurs took a drastic turn for the worse. In a statement made by geologist Dr. Matthew Genge in 1989, an asteroid the size of a city was traveling at speeds of up to 72,000 kilometers an hour and heading straight for Earth. The dinosaurs would barely have seen it coming, but the asteroid would have a catastrophic impact on the evolution of the planet. Given that these events occurred 66 million years ago, understanding the scale of the mayhem is a feat of the imagination and a triumph of science. The escaped piece of space rock from the solar system's asteroid belt smashed into what is now the Gulf of Mexico at around 60 degrees, the most damaging incline possible for life on Earth. And as a result of research, we now know in detail what happened next. By raking over physical evidence extracted by drilling hundreds of meters into the ocean-covered crash site and feeding on-the-ground measurements from the crater into a supercomputer, scientists were able to create 3D simulations of the moment of impact and generation of a fast-moving dust cloud that circled the Earth in a few hours, initiating an impact winter that ended the reign of the dinosaurs. For a few fleeting moments, a fireball that appears far bigger and brighter than the sun streaks through the sky. An instant later, the asteroid slams into Earth with the equivalent power of 10 billion atomic bombs of the size used in World War II. The impact penetrates Earth's crust to a depth of several miles, forming a crater more than 185 kilometers across and vaporizing thousands of cubic miles of rock, reaching temperatures of 5,000 degrees Celsius. Surrounding rock melted to form a pool of superheated melt 70 kilometers across and 3 kilometers deep. The event sets off a chain of global catastrophes that wipe out 80% of life on Earth, including most of the dinosaurs. Anything within 1,000 kilometers would be instantaneously, or within seconds, killed by a fireball. Indeed, any living thing near enough to see it would be dead. 9 seconds after impact, an observer at that distance would have been roasted by a blast of thermal radiation. Trees, grass, and shrubs would have spontaneously burst into flames, and anyone present would have suffered instant third-degree burns over their entire bodies. After the fire comes the flood. Depending on the local topography, the impact would have kicked up a phenomenal tsunami up to 305 meters high. And at the low-end estimate of 10.1 on the Richter scale, the subsequent earthquake would have been more powerful than anything ever measured or experienced by humans. A tumultuous event of this size would be equivalent to all the world's earthquakes for the past 160 years going off simultaneously. At just over 8 minutes post-impact, ejecta would start to spill down, smothering the burning landscapes beneath a blanket of hot grit and ash. Closer to the impact zone, the ground would be buried beneath hundreds, even thousands of feet of rubble. In just one day, nearly 130 meters of material built up inside the crater. About 45 minutes later, a blast of wind would tear through the region at 965 kilometers an hour, scattering debris and flattening anything that might still be standing. Further afield, observers would see the sky darkening with maybe a red glow created by impact debris raining back on Earth. After the red glow, the sky would darken as ash and debris swirling around the globe created a creeping twilight. For the first few hours, there would have been close to total darkness, but soon after that, the sky would begin to lighten. The following weeks, months perhaps, even years were probably somewhere between twilight and a very cloudy day. For Earth, it was life-altering. The asteroid struck rocks that were rich in sulfur, carbon, and organic matter. Unable to photosynthesize, forests, land, and ocean plants died. And wildfires were ignited around the world. Life higher up in the food chain froze or starved to death. Evolution was altered forever. It is assumed by many that the dinosaurs went extinct very quickly following the asteroid strike. But while a great many animals died at the moment of impact and in the weeks immediately following, particularly near Ground Zero, global mass extinction took a while, and it affected certain species more dramatically than others. Many of the small mammals that lived among the dinosaurs, for example, were able to survive because they lived in burrows and could eat just about anything. In addition, species that lived in fresh water typically fared better than those that lived on land. What do you think of those first minutes after the impact? Let us know in the comments and please like this video if you've enjoyed it. If you want to see more videos like this one, then subscribe to Brain Impact for more. Thanks for watching.